far as I remember, I've always been mushroom hunting. Our whole family went. So it was my grandparents and my dad, mom, aunts and uncles. It was a big family affair. Various people have different names for them. As far as we knew, they were always matsutake. They were just a mushroom that we found under pine and fir trees.
In Japanese, matsutake literally means pine mushroom. Matsutake live in symbiotic association with certain trees, notably pines and firs. Patches of matsutake fruit again year after year, allowing mushroom hunters to return to them every fall. Matsutake hunting has been a tradition in Japan for hundreds, possibly thousands, of years. An 8th century poem referred to the smell of matsutake as the autumn aroma.
No way you could describe it, that aroma is so good.
Oh boy, I describe it as kind of cinnamony, but other people will have other descriptions. To me, it's like cinnamon. But it's all by itself. There's no other smell like that.
The fragrance of the mushroom, the taste of the mushroom, the texture of the mushroom is so different than most any other mushroom. It just signifies to us, the Japanese, that it's fall. Special things come in the fall and you savor them. People for generations will talk about matsutake gohan.
Matsutake gohan is shredded matsutake that is cooked with rice so that the rice absorbs the mushroom's flavor.
That's the way of stretching the mushrooms, so everybody could have one.
I think probably the most looked forward to would be sukiyaki. Almost everybody will tell you that.
Sukiyaki is a hot pot dish with meat, vegetables, and broth. The essence of the matsutake is absorbed by the juices, and sukiyaki is a classic fall dish. Every fall, the Oregon Nikkei Endowment goes on an annual matsutake hunt. On this hunt, Japanese Americans and their families go searching for the prized mushrooms. Amy Peterson, a lifelong Oregonian, has volunteered on many of these hunts, passing on knowledge that she learned from family and friends.
Learned the process, learned the land. You need to know where your son is, look up the hills, follow the wind tunnels. Look and see what's different.
You don't go in great groups because you don't want everybody to know where you go. If you tell everybody, there won't be any. Passing that secret down to your own kids, that's very important.
Notice what the ground looks like, but start to notice changes in the ground. You'll see the bump, and you have to kind of determine, is that a critter bump or a mushroom bump?
Peel away the covering, and my God, that's one. Pop it out. Then you brush it off, and you get all the duff and stuff, and then you smell it. That's the test. Gotta smell it. And if it smells right, it's a matsutake.
Developing a collection of patches, and knowing how to spot the mushrooms once you're there, requires an intimacy with the forest that can only come through long-term exposure. And the early immigrants to the Pacific Northwest spent a lot of time in the woods. In the late 1800s, new arrivals to the Northwest were there for the timber, and railroads were cut into the mountains to move trees from the woods to lumber yards. Around 1905, 40% of the railroad workers in Oregon were Issei, our first-generation Japanese immigrants. Like all good stories, there are multiple versions, but some people say that this was how the first Issei found matsutake in the Pacific Northwest.
There was a young man about 17, 18, and they were working on the railroad, and they found the mushrooms. Nobody want to try it. Are you sure it's matsutake? How do you know? And he took the bite of the fresh matsutake, and he chewed and chewed and chewed, and said, if I don't wake up tomorrow morning, they know why. Next morning, he woke up. He said, oh, I'm alive. So it is a good mushroom. So after that, they start to eat.
At first, matsutake was a taste of home in a strange land. But for many Issei, the Northwest became home. Homer's father, Masuo, was one of them. He settled in Hood River, Oregon in 1908. The land around Hood River was a graveyard of stumps left over by the logging operations. Japanese laborers did the hard work of removing stumps with sweat and dynamite. Some Issei were paid in plots of stump land, and after they cleared it, they planted orchards and farms, turning the area into what it is today. Many Nisei, or second-generation children, grew up as country kids, enjoying the outdoors. Matsutake gari, or matsutake hunting, was a favorite fall activity.
The big thing was how big of a mushroom can you find? So you'd find lunch plates, dinner plates.
Highways and cars allowed new mushroom spots to be discovered, and several locations became famous for their crops. By 1940, Japanese families had been settled in the Pacific Northwest for decades. But their lives were about to be upended by war and racism.
When Pearl Harbor happened, it was, came as a shock. And, oh my God, now what's going to happen? 5 days after Pearl Harbor, my father gets arrested by the FBI and the sheriff. They come to our house. My sister and I come home from school. And Fry says, where's Dad? Torareta. He was taken away. That's when we knew things were going to be very bad.
Executive Order 9066 authorized the forced removal of Japanese Americans outside of an exclusion zone set up along the West Coast.
My dad's family went to the fairgrounds, bussed over to the livestock exhibition, put into a cattle stall.
On May 13th, 1942, the Japanese in Hood River were forced to assemble and take the train to an American concentration camp. They rode to their prison on the same railroad that their families had helped build.
I was in Minidoka, I think about block 39. I look at that desert, I told myself, I'm not gonna stay here.
It is impossible to explain or quantify the damage done by the camps. Families were uprooted, livelihoods were lost, and children grew up behind barbed wire. After the war, some Japanese families returned home to the Pacific Northwest, but many did not, because almost everything they had been taken away. The Sansei, or third generation, was raised in the shadow of the camps.
None of my brothers or sisters or I have any Japanese names at all. We have no Japanese middle names, no Japanese first names. We're completely Americanized. We really didn't have a sense of being Japanese.
Despite this, the tradition of matsutake gari continued in the Pacific Northwest.
After the war, I came back to Oregon with my wife, 1951, and my brother. He says, hey, come on, let's go matsutake gari. And we went up the same old mountain. By God, we found him. By that time, we had a kid, and so we took our kids on the back. So she grew up with that. She can't remember where she first did it.
It seems that for many Japanese Oregonians, matsutake hunting is not just about connecting to their Japanese heritage. It's about their sense of place here and their childhood memories of picking matsutake in the northwestern woods.
Having the foraging part, you know, going off into the forest and forgetting all your cares and woes and just doing something fun as a family, you know, it was relaxing and nice. The fall leaves change color, the smells change, the streams flow, and it's just such a calming effect because it's just so beautiful.